Hey everyone, it's Will from Crooked Chicken. Welcome back to another video. I thank you for coming and checking out my channel and checking out my videos. It's really appreciated. Today we're going to be talking about the CW and all the recent news coming out of there. The last few months, really, it's been all about the new leadership that's in place, canceling shows, going in new directions, and just all around ruining a legacy for the most part. We all know that here in the last few months, we've had the cancellation of several DC properties. Some, it was time for them to go. Others didn't really get the chance to get up off their feet. But then again, with the new leadership, they are wanting to, like I said, go in a different direction. First, we had the cancellations of Batwoman and DC Legends and Stargirl most recently. And with the upcoming final season of The Flash, it will be the official death of the Arrowverse, a universe that was built within the last decade that really made the channel what it is, brought in the audience, brought in the views and everything that they had, and just built this fan base that is just unbeatable in every aspect. You know, we started off with Arrow, then The Flash, then DC Legends, and so on. And after the death of Arrow, it just started to really go downhill. And most recently, with the upcoming last season of The Flash, I believe slated to premiere in either January or February or somewhere in the beginning of the next year, there's been a lot of on-scene photos of what's currently filming and the big bad for this season, as well as a couple surprise cameos. The big bad this year is going to be Red Death. Now, he's been teased periodically throughout the history of the series, and it looks like we're finally going to get him for the final season. And as if you are not familiar with Red Death, he's actually a version of Bruce Wayne who actually merges with the Flash and kind of loses his mind for the most part and just kind of goes on murderous rampages and everything out to get other speedsters, from what I understand. And this version, I don't know what they're planning, because they kind of stay away from the idea of Bruce Wayne. And I think what they're planning on doing, judging by all the pictures that are out there, we're going to get Batwoman back to probably close off her storyline, because she was canceled abruptly. Even though it was not the best show in the world, it probably should have been able to finish how it needed to, but it was one of the many shows that I was canceled very abruptly. And so they're trying to, I believe, close off her storyline and kind of introduce others, but then at the same time, kind of bring everything to a proper close with the fact that this season of The Flash is only going to be 13 episodes. Unfortunately, with the last season of The Flash, we are also coming up on a questionable last season of Superman and Lois. Now, Superman and Lois has been a very high-performing show on the CW. The last two seasons have just been stellar, and with the new leadership in place, there's not been any definitive talk about it, but there has been whispers that possibly the upcoming season of Superman and Lois could be its last, with it only having three seasons. And honestly, with the recasting of Jonathan Kent, earlier in the summer it was reported and confirmed that Jordan Elsass was actually going to leave the role to take care of himself, as he was suffering from some mental health issues and he just wanted to take some time off, possibly not returning to acting for quite a while. So they turn around and they actually recasted his role with a kind of an unknown, but that always leaves kind of a questionable thing kind of up in the air when they recast a role, especially on an established character that people have grown to love and everything. So it really begs to question if the show wouldn't have got canceled anyways just because of lack of viewership due to them recasting a primary role, and people kind of walking away from it because of that. So it's really, really a big question mark up in the air what they're going to do as far as Superman and Lois. And not only that, with CW going in the direction it's going, I've actually read that the new leadership actually is wanting to go so much in a different direction that they're wanting to bring back an audience that was into shows like Whose Line Is Anyway, which is right there just kind of signing the death certificate for this fucking channel. It's really kind of a slap in the face to all the people that have been really dedicated to this channel pretty much ever since it started. This channel started back when Smallville was still going, and to kind of close out and cancel all these shows randomly, I mean, it's just kind of a slap to the face to us that have been pretty loyal to the channel, because not only with the cancellation of all these late shows that have been around a handful of years, some longer than others, they're also not even putting full season orders for new shows. We had Independence, which was the Walker prequel, and then we also had the prequel for Supernatural, which was the Winchesters, which I can personally say it would not be the worst thing in the world if they did cancel that show, just because I have tried to power through that show and really give it a chance. Being a huge fan of Supernatural, I watched all 15 years, you know, that's basically half of my life right there that I dedicated to a show, and then they bring this prequel in and it's not doing it justice at all. It's really starting to reflect in the viewership and in the ratings and everything. I really don't see the show getting past the 13 episode order that it did initially get. For sure, I don't see it getting a second season at all. It's just been a, you know, I'm not trying to be funny here, but it's been a horror show of a show. It's just downright not doing well, not performing well with people that were huge fans of Supernatural. It's been the general consensus that the show just sucks, which is unfortunate because, you know, you had Jensen Ackles at the helm producing it and everything with his wife, and it's just been kind of really disappointing. So, and also with these other shows that may not have a future with the channel, you also had the trailer for Gotham Knights come out with Comic-Con and everybody, and pretty much everyone that saw that trailer tore it apart, me included. I have a review on my channel back from earlier this summer. It looked absolutely terrible, and there's not been any other word about that show, if it's going to even premiere or what their plans are with that show. So it's just a very bleak future for the CW as a whole. Anyways, guys, I think that will do it. If you enjoyed this video, please check out the rest of my channel. Leave comments, leave thumbs up, and most importantly, if you feel so inclined, subscribe to the channel. I'd really appreciate it. So until next time, guys, take care. Bye.